why did you do it that way?
We had always planned, quite frankly, for me to announce that week that I would be leaving The View. And when I say we, I mean ABC, Barbara, Bill, our executive producers, and me. When they first told me that my contract was not going to be renewed, they asked me to stay to a certain date, specifically to July 13th. And they specifically said what week they wanted me to talk about it, and that I could go out on my own terms. And I had been planning to do it on Thursday.
But
Larry, if you think about it, I was told April 21st that my contract wasn't going to be renewed. So for 2 months, I've been going to The View every single day, doing my job 100% professionally. And through it all, every single week, there'd be news reports, speculation, rumor, gossip, innuendo, and it was relentless. And Monday, I woke up and there was another story, and the countdown to star leaving The View with a date definite. Now, no one knew that information but executives and me. And then Tuesday,
so you're saying somebody leaked it?
Absolutely. There's no question that that was done. And then Tuesday morning, I woke up, and it was more of it. And I realized it was turning into a circus atmosphere. And the viewers deserved, after 9 years, me to not go out in a circus atmosphere.
But Barbara Walters told me that she had arranged with you, your agent, and everybody to have a goodbye on Thursday. They were going to do a whole kind of tribute to you for a full hour, showing highlights of your past 9 years with The View. That's not true?
Actually, Larry, I never agreed to any of that. I agreed that I would make the announcement that I would leave on Thursday. As a matter of fact, I specifically said I did not want a big, long, large tribute. I didn't feel that way after being told that my contract was not going to be renewed.
Did you feel you were betrayed?
You know, that's such a tough word. I looked at it as a business decision. In April, when I was told that the numbers weren't adding up and that they were going to make a change, emotionally, you go, after 9 years, you want to be angry and upset, but I stepped back. 200,000 people a year get a pink slip, so I said, be professional. People's jobs depend on you. And I went to work, and I said, it's a business decision. But it then became very, very personal in the media, and that started to hurt.
Why not wait till Thursday?
When you wake up Tuesday morning, and the night before, there's tabloids outside your house, to the point where I couldn't even go outside and walk my dog. Tuesday morning, I said, I need to do this on my own terms. I called my pastor, and we talked about it. We prayed, and I said, Tuesday, I'm going to tell what's going on. And I did.
When I spoke to Barbara yesterday, one of the things she was most upset about was that you had talked to People magazine before Tuesday.
Yes.
You had taken pictures.
Yes.
For publication this week. You had told your whole story of being fired. And yet, on the air, it looked like you quit.
Well, on the air, I said I was moving, the show was moving in another direction, and I will not be returning to The View. That's actually what I said. And from the beginning, from April, because I really want you to look back to when it was first decided, I was told you'll be able to leave on your own terms. The terms I chose was to tell the truth. I mean, I'm not used to being blasted for telling the truth.
Why did you talk to People magazine before Tuesday?
Because I really wanted the viewers. I thought they deserved to know. If I was going to make the decision that week, Thursday, there was going to be a time that the viewers wanted to know what actually happened.
Why didn't you tell Barbara that you'd spoken to People?
Pretty much probably the same reason she hasn't spoken to me yet. She called you to talk to you about it. She didn't speak to me.
Well, she told me after the fact, though.
But Larry, you should know, I wasn't told by Barbara that my contract was not being renewed. My agent was told. And then I was told, I want you to know how it happened.
She told me it was not her decision. It was ABC's decision.
But
she held it off for a while. They wanted to do it earlier. Is that true?
Listen, I was told in April, on April 21st, as a matter of fact, my agent was called the night before, and then my agent called my managers and my husband, and Al got on a plane and flew to me where I was in Phoenix to tell me himself. I'm sad that the platform that I helped to build was used in a way to attack me professionally.
You think you were attacked there?
Well, I'll leave that to the viewers to decide. But, you know, Larry, I guess our show gave me the opportunity to experience a lot of emotions. And I remember several months ago, there was a hot topic. And the hot topic was on the question of loyalty. The discussion was, what do you do when a friend is disloyal? How do you react? And I was very vehement when someone you counted as a friend is disloyal. You cannot meet that with disloyalty.